Hello. Good evening.
Hello.
Hi. How was your day? Fine. Hello.
I'm fine.
Nice. What time is in El Salvador? 8. Almost 8. Here in Panama, it is almost 9. We are 1 hour ahead. Can you hear me well? Yes. Jacqueline, can you hear me well?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Now, yesterday we haven't finished, but it's still 1 minute to go. How are you doing with the platform? ¿Cómo van con la plataforma?
Yo me adelanté porque no estuve en la primera clase.
It's okay. It's okay. I told you that you can go ahead. Ustedes pueden ir más adelante. Es más, si ustedes terminan en una semana, no hay problema.
Okay.
Solo regresan a darnos copias. And any questions that you have, you may work ahead. And any questions that you have, you may contact me by WhatsApp. Okay, they're in the
okay.
group, and I can answer the questions, because it's better if the questions are through the WhatsApp group, because there could be other classmates with the same problem, and they may check there the answers. Okay. Now it's time to go. We had the we haven't answered this yesterday. Wait.
Teacher,
yes.
The section 3 and the 3.13, creo que es el apartado, no recuerdo.
Uh-huh.
Que se menciona de which one wants, no me ha quedado muy claro ese punto.
Okay, let me see. Section 3.
Yes.
Before the midterm exam?
Perdón?
Before the midterm exam? Three eleven.
Sí, creo que es 3.11 o 3.13, no me recuerdo muy bien. Espérame, voy a revisar aquí la
I am sharing the platform.
Ahorita, espérame.
here. 3.11, comparisons with adjectives. 3.8, which one do you prefer? That one?
Yes, ese, ese.
Okay. Which one do you prefer? What is that you don't understand about it?
No comprendo bien en qué momento es que se va a usar one y cuando es once.
Oh, okay. Which one do you prefer? Okay. Which one is when you have to choose one? What, this or this? Okay. And, okay. And when you say this ones, is when you are showing more than one. Once es más de uno. Y one es solo uno.
Entonces, o sea que once es, va a ser el plural y one el singular. Cuando se usen el de, por ejemplo, this one, the necklace, no sé cómo se dice.
Necklace.
Ajá, necklace, ajá. Uh-huh. Y digamos, sería this one's earrings, o así sería.
Which one do you prefer? Look, these jackets are really nice. Which one do you prefer? I like the wool one better. The wool one? Why? It looks warmer. Well, I like the leather one.
Colors. Would you like to try it on?
No. That's okay. But thanks anyway.
You're welcome.
Notice how the girls are talking about their preferences. In the next class, we will study how to express preferences and comparisons.
Well, when it says which one, is because you have to choose just one.
Okay.
O sea, está enseñando dos. Look at these jackets. Está enseñando dos, ¿verdad? Pero después dice, which one do you prefer? ¿Cuál de ellos prefiere? O sea, le está dando a escoger solo uno. Which one? Pero si ya usted dice, which ones, es porque se está refiriendo a más de uno.
Ok, thank you, teacher.
O sea que vaya, por ejemplo, si yo le estoy enseñando varias opciones, o hay varias opciones, más de solo dos, y yo tal vez le quiero regalar dos cosas o tres cosas, entonces, which ones do you prefer? Le estoy dando a escoger más de solo uno.
Ok.
¿Verdad? Entonces, pero si usted solo va a escoger uno, es which one. Entonces se dice one. Pero si usted dice which ones, es porque le va a escoger más de uno. O sea que, digamos, usted, hay varias camisetas. Entonces, which ones do you prefer? Entonces usted me puede decir the red one, the blue one, the yellow one. Está escogiendo más de uno.
En este caso, las respuestas siempre serían, digamos,
si le digo, están diciendo, si le están diciendo which one, es solo una tiene que escoger. Pero si
ajá, y ahí yo tendría ones, que responder.
Es más de uno.
Ajá, y ahí tendría que responder, digamos, de one jacket de red color, por ejemplo. ¿Tengo que usar el one red, o ya no?
De red, de red jacket. No, ya no necesita decir one, porque está escogiendo solo una cosa y está diciendo a cuál se refiere. The red jacket.
Ok, thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Ven, cuando les digo que no necesitan esperar hasta que lleguemos ahí para preguntar, porque sí, ella ya va tranquila y sigue con su... Now, we have Remember that we were. ¿Ya están viendo este? Sí, ¿verdad?
Yes, perdón.
What's in the name? With... ¿Están viendo? ¿Lo estoy compartiendo o no?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, teacher. Okay. Es que algunas veces creo que estoy compartiendo y no estoy compartiendo. Okay. What's in a name? Okay. We already read it, but I will read it again in order to answer the questions because we missed to answer the questions. Okay. Now, what's in a name? Look at the names in the article. Do you know any people with these names? What are they like? Your name is very important. When you think of yourself, you probably think of your name first. It is an important part of your identity. Right now, the two most popular names for babies in the United States are Jacob for boys and Emily for girls. Why are these names popular? And why are some names unpopular? Names can become popular because of famous actors, TV or book characters, or athletes. Popular names suggest very positive things. Unpopular names suggest negative things. Surprisingly, people generally agree on the way they feel about names. Here are some common opinions about names from a recent survey. George, average, boring. Jacob, creative, friendly. Michael, good looking, athletic. Stanley, nerdy, serious. Okay. Betty, old fashioned, average. I'm old fashioned. Emily, independent, adventurous. Jane, plain, ordinary. Nicole, beautiful, intelligent. Okay. Now, so why do parents give their children unpopular names? The biggest reason is tradition. Many people are named after a family member. Of course, opinions can change over time. A name that is unpopular now might become popular in the future. That's good news for all the Georges and Berries out there. In my case, I have three children. The first one was the father who chose the name. The second one was me, the one who chose the name. And in the third one, both of us, okay? But the funny thing is that the third one has a very strange name. The second name is very strange because I want to name one of my children and he was the last one. Before my father, and my father's name was Otoniel, so I said this one will be Otoniel, and then my husband said that he wants him to be called as his brother, that his brother never had a son, just daughters, and my husband and we had three sons. So he wants to name after his brothers, that his brother's name was Daniel. And I say, well, the only thing is that we have to choose because I won't call my son Daniel Otoniel because Iel, I don't like it. Either he will be called Dani Otoniel or Otto Daniel. But Otto Daniel, they could what's the name of this? Bullying him because they can say Otro Daniel. And then at the end, he decided to call him Dani Otoniel. Okay. But nowadays, my son say, why did you call me Dani Otoniel? And then I ask him, you don't like Otoniel? No, I don't like Danny. I thought that he was complaining about Otoniel because Otoniel is very strange for nowadays, no? But he was complaining about Danny, not about Otoniel. I like Otoniel. Otoniel is the first judge in the Bible. Okay. Now, your name is part of your identity. It is true or false? According to the reading.
It's true.
Okay, true. It's true. Cuando salgan así, cuadrados, tengan cuidado, porque pueden poner ambos. Y ¿cómo se llama? Porque, vaya, por ejemplo, si pongo yo que sí, quedan ambos. Entonces, fíjense bien que estén marcando solo uno, ¿ok? Cuando salen los cuadrados, pueden marcar ambos y eso no, o sea, la respuesta es solo uno, ¿ok? People often feel the same way about a particular name. It's true or false?
True.
It's true, okay? Because it says that the survey, almost all the people feel the same about it. Now, boys' names are more popular than girls' names.
False.
People are often named after family members. True or false?
True.
Okay. Opinions about names can change?
It's true.
Okay. Now let's see. Okay, correct. You are great. Okay. Any questions? Because this is the last lesson from the section. Any questions about the whole section?
No, please.
Okay. I hope that by now everybody is up to here, okay? Because for this week, we had to finish the first two sections, okay? At least. Now, I have my PPT for class number 3. I forgot to put here 3. Okay. Aquí sí le puse, o sea, le cambié el nombre a la hora de guardarlo, pero aquí no le puse. Now. Somebody can read it, please.
By education, I mean all round drawing of the best in child and men in body, men and spirit.
Okay.
I understand.
Okay. Do you understand that? ¿Entienden qué significa?
No.
Que la educación debe de significar todo, o sea, lo mejor de un niño y lo mejor de un hombre, ¿verdad? Entonces, porque vaya en cuerpo, mente y espíritu, ¿verdad? Entonces, no debemos, o sea, que la educación no debe de estar centrada solamente en lo que va a aprender usted mentalmente, sino que debe de fijarse en que su cuerpo, su mente y su espíritu, entonces cuando estamos hablando de espíritu es cuando estamos hablando de valores, ¿verdad? O sea, que todo debe de ser una sola cosa, ¿sí? El profesor que se centra solamente en darle información no es un buen profesor. sea, el profesor debe de preocuparse en usted como un ser total, o sea, mente, cuerpo y espíritu. ¿Verdad? I like that. Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. Now, in this lesson, participants will listen to a conversation about jobs using WH questions words as well as statements. Okay. Now, we have a conversation. Where do you work? Where do you work?
Where do you work?
Okay.
Where do you
work? I will read it all first. You follow the reading and then we will do it together. And after that, we will practice it in couples. Well, where do you work, Andrea? I work at Thomas Cook Travel. Oh, really? What do you do there? I'm a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America like Peru. How interesting. Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And who do you do? Yo creo que aquí es what do you do? Creo que me equivoqué. Yo creo que es what do you do?
Sí, es what do you do.
Okay. Now, I'm a student and I have a part-time job too. Oh, where do you work? In a fast food restaurant. Which restaurant? Hamburger Heaven. Okay. Now, permítanme, solo voy a corregir. Okay. Okay, now. Repeat after me. Where do you work, Andrea?
Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
What do you do there?
I'm a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America like Peru.
I take people on tours to countries in South America like Peru.
How interesting.
How interesting.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you do?
Yes, it's a great job.
What do you do? I'm a student and I have a part-time job too.
I have a part-time job too.
Where do you work? In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Hamburger Heaven.
Fíjense que aquí me faltó otra cosita. Ok. Now, the first two volunteers, please. Primero dos voluntarios. Ok, Yancy Mayen and Mateo Meléndez. Mateo, you will be Jason. And Yancy will be Andrea. Go ahead.
Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I'm a guide. I take people on tour to countries in South America, like Peru.
Oh, interesting.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you do?
I'm a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Heaven.
Hamburger Heaven.
Okay, thank you. Now, other two volunteers, please. Lisette Esmeralda. And? Floridalia. Okay, Lisette, you first and then Flor.
Okay.
Okay, teacher. Okay. Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I take people on tours to country in South America. I like Peru.
Okay. Oh, interesting.
Yes, it is a great job. I love it. And what do you do? What do you do?
I am a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Okay, thank you very much. Just repeat this. I take people on tours.
I take people on tours.
Mm-hmm. I'm a guide. Like Peru. Por ahí dijeron, I like Peru. Es I like Peru, sin el I al principio, ¿ok?
Ok.
Now, other two volunteers, please. Verónica Godoy and Rodrigo Vidal. Rodrigo, you are Jason. And Verónica, you are Andrea.
Hola. Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I'm a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America, like Peru.
Oh, interesting.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you do?
I'm a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Okay, thank you very much. Other two people, please. Melida and Carla Albergue, could you help us? Melida, you go first and then Carla, please.
Okay. ¿Me escuchan?
Yes, we can hear you.
Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I am a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America, like Peru.
Oh, interesting.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you do?
I am a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Okay, thank you very much. Well, actually, I just want to comment about these two jobs. How nice to work as a guide, you know? Because even if you don't earn too much money, you had your tours for free. Si usted va, usted viaja de gratis. ¿Cuánto cuesta un viaje? Y le dan viaje, comida, estadía y toda la cosa y todavía le pagan. Nice. I guess that is a very good job, but it's a job for someone that has no family. ¿Verdad? O sea, es un trabajo para alguien que no tenga familia, o sea, que no tenga que estar en cierto lugar a cierta hora. Por ejemplo, yo no me hubiera podido dar el lujo de tener un trabajo así, aunque me hubiera gustado, ¿verdad? Porque con tres hijos, y bueno, y a cada uno de mis hijos le he dado de mamar 3 años y medio. O sea, no había chance, yo era la vaca, pues. Y bueno, y yo amamantando 3 años y medio y trabajando en 3 lugares diferentes mientras estaba criando. O sea que, solo Dios conmigo. Porque me pongo a pensar, nunca compré, mis hijos no saben lo que es tomar pacha. Yo nunca compré, o sea, pacha de leche hecha aparte, ¿verdad? Porque yo lo que hacía era que en la mañanita, lo más solo despertarse era mi rutina. Me lo ponía en un pecho mientras me sacaba en el otro, porque it's better if you have the baby taking the milk out of you. Porque si no, cuesta más. Si uno se lo está sacando así en seco, eso cuesta. Entonces, mientras el niño está en un lado, usted saca más luego de la otra. Entonces, le dejaba su pachita para la mañana. En la tarde que llegaba, o sea, al mediodía, después del mediodía, al nomás llegar me bañaba y a darle. Entonces, era al revés, me lo ponía en la otra y sacándomela del otro, para dejarle para en la tarde. Y cuando ya llegaba en la tarde, otra vez a bañarme y otra vez en la misma rutina y así, ¿verdad? Porque como trabajaba en 3 lugares, pero siempre entre lugar y lugar llegaba a la casa porque tenía que ir a fungir de vaca. But I will never change. I would never change that period of my children's life. O sea, nunca cambiaría ese periodo. En ese momento, yo sabía que era sacrificio para mí, pero sabía que le estaba dando una mejor vida a mis hijos, que les estaba dando salud, les estaba dando seguridad, ¿verdad? Porque el hecho de que una madre esté amamantando a su hijo le da seguridad al niño, ¿verdad? Y es una forma también de poder interactuar y darles cariño en ese momento. O sea, es cuando más se puede estar en contacto con un hijo y demostrarle que uno lo quiere. Entonces, de toda la crianza de mis hijos, eso es lo que más atesoro. In each of them, call my breast in their own way. Cada uno de ellos le puso su propio nombre a mis pechos. Ya que estábamos hablando de nombre, One, the first one call it ricas. The second one call it chiche, normal. And the other one called them mías. So they were ricas, chiches, mías. It was very funny. When I talk to them and I make them remember, they laugh with me because each of them called them their way. O sea, cada uno le había puesto su nombre a sus asuntos esos. Entonces, cuando pedía, mami, dame rica, me decía el mayor. Y el segundo le decía chiche. Y el tercero, mías. Ese es el más posesivo, ese es el más posesivo de mis tres hijos. Todavía lo es. Okay, now, other two volunteers, please. Flor Idalia, could you help us with Freddy Quijano? Freddy, you go first, and then Flor, please.
Okay. I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do?
I'm a guide. I take people on tours to country in South America, like South. Peru.
South
America. South
America. Remember South what I America. Told you that in English they don't respect the vowels as we do. Okay? O sea, en inglés ellos no respetan las vocales como nosotros. O sea, si se dan cuenta, ahí no hay por ningún lado una A. Sin embargo, suena South. ¿Ok?
South. Okay.
Ok. Remember that. South America.
Ok.
Uh-huh. Like Peru.
Like Peru.
Ok. Freddy?
Oh, interesting.
Ay, no, yeah. Freddy, por favor, de veras que se suene que es interesante. How interesting. Okay. Okay. How interesting. Okay, better. Thank you. Now, continue, Flo.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you think? What do you do?
Aquí sucede lo que les he dicho, que el do puede servir como auxiliar y también como verbo. Aquí está siendo usado el primero do es el auxiliar y el segundo do es como verbo principal. Entonces, what do you do? Okay.
Okay.
I am a student. I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
I am fast food restaurant.
No, in a fast food
restaurant.
Okay.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Haven.
Okay, thank you very much. And sorry, Freddy, but I always when we have exclamation marks, we have to try to exclaim. Okay, so that's why I asked you to do it again, because if you keep the voice like you are like you are a poker player, it's not good with the English. You have to be more expressive in order to express your feelings with the other language. Okay.
Okay.
Now, two other volunteers. Rodrigo, have you done it? ¿Rodrigo ya lo hizo?
Rodrigo Vidal.
Ajá.
Sí, ya, ya.
Ok. ¿Qué hay otro Rodrigo? Carlos Membreño, could you help us?
Okay.
Okay, Carlos, and who wants to go with Carlos? Okay, Lourdes, could you help us?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I'm a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America, like Peru.
How interesting.
Yes, it's a great job. I love it. And what do you do?
I'm a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger Heaven.
Okay, thank you very much. Don Carlos, you have a very nice voice. You should go and work in a radio.
No.
No, you should work in a radio. In a radio station. You have a very nice voice. Now, Remberdo Alejandro, could you help us, please? And Claudia Quintanilla? No. Gemima Angélica? Could you help us?
Yes.
Okay, now, Remberto and Gemima.
Okay, where do you work, Andrea?
I work at Thomas Cook Travel.
Oh, really? What do you do there?
I'm a guide. I take people on tours to countries in South America like Peru.
Oh. Interesting.
Yes, it's a good job. I love it. And what do you do?
I am a student and I have a part-time job too.
Oh, where do you work?
In a fast food restaurant.
Which restaurant?
Hamburger. Hey.
Okay, thank you. It just is part-time job. Part-time job.
Part-time job.
Okay, and I'm a guide. I'm a guide. No, no es I'm a guy. I'm a guide. Okay, se tiene que oír la D al final, guide. Porque si solo dice guy, es como que dijera chico, ¿ok? Entonces es guide. Y guy se escribe diferente. Guy es G-A-Y, pero se oye así, guy. Entonces por eso uno tiene que decir guide. Para que se oiga la diferencia entre guy y guide. ¿Ok? Recuerdan que yo les he dicho que con inglés hay que tener mucho cuidado con la pronunciación. Porque con una cosita que cambie un poquitito, ya significa otra cosa. ¿Ok? Lesson objective. By the end of this lesson, participants will be able to understand and use simple present. ¿Ok? Aquí me tomé esto sí está en la plataforma, esto sí está en la plataforma, pero ya van a ver unas cositas que puse por ahí. que no están en la plataforma, pero consideré que era importante que lo tuvieran. Now, repeat after me. What do you do?
What do you do?
I'm a student.
I'm a student.
And I have a part-time job.
And I have a part-time job.
Disculpen, este es where. Where do you work?
Where do you work?
I work at a restaurant.
I work at a restaurant.
También podrían decir, I work in a restaurant.
I work in a restaurant.
O sea, puede ser, I work at a restaurant or I work in a restaurant. Where do you go to school?
Where do you go to school?
I go to the University of Texas.
I go to the University of Texas.
Where does Andrea work?
Where does Andrea work?
She works at Thomas Cook Travel.
What does she do?
She's a guide. She takes people on tours. How does she like it?
She loves it.
Okay. Bueno, si se fijan ustedes aquí, cuando está preguntando a una segunda persona, dice, what do you do? O sea, ¿en qué trabaja? What do you do? Y cuando estamos preguntando sobre una tercera persona, dice, where does Andrea work? Or what does she do? Entonces, si se fijan aquí, does es tercera persona del singular porque estamos hablando de she. En cambio, aquí es do. Acuérdense que les dije que aquí está trabajando como auxiliar. Entonces, aquí estás, pero cuando pasa a ser das en el auxiliar, su forma simple se queda como do, ¿verdad? Y por eso es what does she do. Sería what does he do, what does it do, ¿verdad? Pero es what do you do.
Excuse me, teacher.
Dígame.
I have a question.
Yes.
What is the difference between what do you do and what you're doing? Thank you.
What do you do se está refiriendo a qué hace usted, digamos, para ganarse la vida, ¿verdad? Para trabajar. O sea, what do you do? ¿Qué hace? Como ¿en qué trabajas?
In English, please.
When you say what do you do is what is your labor, what you are working on. But when you say what are you doing is like how are you? Okay. That's why you say what are you doing? I'm fine. Okay, it's like, how are you? Do you understand that? Hello?
For example, what you do is, for example, a profession?
Yes, you are asking.
What do you do, for example?
Not a profession, but a job. Because remember that you can have another profession and be working in something else. It's actually what you do.
For example, what are you doing? For example, is what is your job in this moment? Right now, for example, I job in the city hall, for example. What do you do? An architect or an psychology, for example?
No. If you say, what are you doing? Okay. Is at the moment, how do you feel? Or what you are doing? It depends on the context. Okay. But if you ask somebody, what are you doing? Is like, how are you? And when somebody tells you, what are you doing? You say, I'm fine, or I'm doing this and this, okay? Or pretty good, okay? But if you ask, what do you do? Is the job that you are in the present time. The job, okay. The job, not the profession. Because sometimes people have one profession, but it's working something else.
Okay, thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. Now, simple present, WH questions and statements. Okay. For simple present, these are the other people, like I, you, we, they, and he and she is third person singular. Okay, this is all the other personal pronouns, and this is just he, she, and it. Third person singular. We use the verb for simple present, affirmative, like the base form for all the other personal pronouns. But for he, she, and it, which is the third person singular, there is something that is called verb agreement. Then we have for all the other persons work, and for he, she, and it works. Now we will be doing both. Please repeat after me. Work works.
Work works.
Take takes.
Take takes.
Study studies.
Study studies.
He teaches.
He teaches.
Do that.
Do that.
Go goes.
Go go
goes.
Have has.
Have has.
Okay.
Has.
Now, this is the simple present timeline. Okay, you may talk about present the things that are happening. Okay. Right now, yeah, at the moment of speaking, or present activity, or you can also talk about habits and routines using the present tense, okay? And you may also use the present tense for scheduled future activities, okay? Something that you know that you have to do, maybe like a routine as well, okay? You may use the present time. O sea, que el presente también puede ser usado como un futuro de algo que usted ya lo tiene como previsto, como que fuera una rutina.
Okay? Going to.
You can use it as a future, a scheduled future activity, the present time. And here, repeat after me. We use the present simple.
We use the present simple.
We use the present simple
To describe general facts. Repeated actions and habits. And facts that are always true. Okay, general facts. I like milk.
I like milk.
Maria plays basketball.
Maria plays basketball.
They speak Japanese.
They speak Japanese.
We live in Mexico.
We live in Mexico.
Repeated actions and habits. Harry often arrives late.
Harry often arrives late.
I usually get up at six.
Things that are always true.
The sun rises in the east. The earth goes around the sun.
The earth goes around the sun.
Okay. Any doubt about this? O sea, les estoy dando cosas que no estaban en la plataforma. ¿Alguna duda? General facts, repeated actions and habits, and things that are always true. O sea, para eso se ocupa el presente simple. ¿No tienen dudas? Okay, seguimos. Now, simple present third person verb agreement. Esto es lo que les decía. Para la tercera persona, cuando estamos hablando de oraciones en afirmativo, en la tercera persona el verbo va a cambiar, ¿verdad? Y hay ciertas reglas para seguir en ese cambio del verbo. Entonces, most verbs in English form the third person singular by adding s to the base form, ¿verdad? Y aquí les estoy haciendo la aclaración que se hacen los cambios solo para la tercera persona del singular en oraciones afirmativas. Ya después vamos a ver por qué estoy diciendo que en oraciones afirmativas. Entonces, decimos. Repeat after me. Sing, sings.
Sing, sings.
Give, gives.
Require, requires. ¿Verdad? Entonces, estos son ejemplos de que la mayoría de verbos solo se les agrega S. Okay. Now, we have the other one. Verbs ending in O, CH, S, SH, X, or Z form the third person singular by adding ES. For example, go goes.
Go goes.
Watch go, go. Watches.
Watch watches.
Miss misses. Watch,
watch. Miss misses.
Rush rushes. Mixes.
Mixes.
Buzz buzzes.
Mix.
Okay. Bears ending in a consonant Y plus Y, such as try, form the third person singular by changing the Y to I and adding ES. Pero está diciendo que es va consonante y Y. O sea, consonante Y. Si es vocal Y, solo se le agrega S. Pero si es consonante Y, cambia la Y por I latina y se le agrega ES. ¿Ok? Entonces sería try, tries. Si se fijan, cambia la Y esta Y por I latina y le agregamos ES. ¿Ok? Pero solo si la que precede a la Y es consonante. Si la que precede a la Y es una vocal, entonces solo se le agrega S, como say, say, says, ¿verdad? Estas son las tres, estas son las tres reglas para el third person singular verb agreement. ¿Alguna duda o consulta?
What does mean agreement?
Agreement es que, por ejemplo, está el que
agregar.
Siempre va a ser así, es como, como un agreement es ponerse de acuerdo, ¿verdad? Pero entonces el verbo agreement es que en tercera persona usted va a tener que aplicar cualquiera de estas reglas para cuando se esté refiriendo a la forma afirmativa. Porque acordémonos que también hay forma negativa y forma interrogativa. Pero ahí en ese caso, el verbo que recibe el agreement es el auxiliar. Por eso es que pasa de do a das. Pero el verbo principal queda en su forma simple. Por eso les dije que vaya, por ejemplo, aquí están los ejemplos. Afirmativo, negativo, interrogativo. Este interrogativo es lo que conocemos también como yes, no question. Entonces, si ustedes se fijan, va sujeto, verbo, complemento. Aquí, con todas las otras personas, va el verbo en su base form. Pero para tercera persona, que es he, and she y también it, aquí sí va el verbo con el agreement que les acabo de decir.
Un acuerdo, yes.
Ajá. Entonces, he goes, she watches, ¿verdad? Pero si nos fijamos aquí, el que tiene el agreement aquí es el auxiliar, doesn't, ¿verdad? El verbo principal va a ir en su forma simple. Pasa de goes a go. De watches a watch. Y el que tiene el agreement es el auxiliar. Lo mismo aquí en el interrogativo. El que va en tercera persona es el auxiliar. El verbo principal va en su forma simple. ¿Verdad?
Yes.
Esto es importante que lo manejen porque es algo que no cambia. O sea, así es. Así es siempre. Entonces, ¿alguna duda o consulta? Esto se lo voy a pasar al WhatsApp, al grupo de WhatsApp, porque además es material que no está
en la plataforma,
o sea, sí está, pero no está explicadito, ¿verdad? Sino que solo así como un brochazo. Entonces yo preferí darles las reglas, porque esas reglas se aplican a cualquier verbo, ¿verdad? O sea, si usted busca cualquier lista de verbos y usted les aplica esto, así es, ¿verdad? A la mayoría solo se le agrega S, pero los que terminan en O, CH, SS, SH, X y Z, a eso se le agrega ES. Y los que terminan en consonante más Y, se cambia la Y por I latina y se le agrega ES. Eso es tanto en los verbos regulares como en los verbos irregulares. ¿Verdad? Es para el presente, para el agreement del presente simple. ¿Verdad? Entonces aquí les pongo también, porque como se estaba hablando en el objetivo, decía que estábamos viendo los interrogativos. Entonces, esta es la fórmula para la yes, no questions. And this is the formula for the WH question, ¿verdad? Si le estoy dando una fórmula es porque así es como se escriben realmente las preguntas. The auxiliary, subject, verb, complement. WH word, auxiliary, subject, verb, and complement. Entonces, usted solo va sustituyendo en la fórmula y usted puede armar sus propias preguntas. O sus propias oraciones en este caso, ¿verdad? Sujeto, verbo, complemento. Acuérdese solamente que el sujeto tiene que estar en agreement con el verbo. Entonces, si el sujeto es cualquiera de las otras personas, el verbo va en su base form. Pero si es tercera persona de singular, tiene que aplicarle las reglas, de las tres reglas, la que aplique a ese verbo. ¿Ok?
Yes, miss.
Ok, entonces nos quedamos aquí y mañana vamos a terminar con el knowledge check, ¿verdad? Porque ya terminó la hora. Okay. Ok. See you tomorrow.
See you.
Cualquier duda o consulta, me la pueden hacer por WhatsApp también. Ok.
Ok. Yes. Thank you.
Ok. Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Ok. Bye bye.
Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Take care.